Millions of Americans are walking around with heart disease and they don't even know it. Joining us now to discuss is Dr. Vivesh Kumar from the Orlando Health Heart and Vascular Institute. Thanks so much for being here with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
So when you look at the statistics, nearly half of all Americans have high blood pressure and about 10% of them have high cholesterol. Those numbers sound crazy. What are we doing wrong?
So you're exactly right. High blood pressure and high cholesterol is really an epidemic, and there are a lot of things that lead to high blood pressure and high cholesterol. Diet, sedentary lifestyle, lack of exercise, smoking, all of these things are really contributing to increased risk of cardiovascular disease.
Okay, so when we talk about diet, there are so many different approaches out there. We can go low carb, we can go vegan, we can go paleo. Which one do you think works the best for controlling heart disease?
So you're right. I mean, there's a lot of different types of diets out there, and truthfully, all of them are actually very good at helping people to lose weight. Now, when we're actually talking about reducing the risk of developing heart disease, perhaps the most well-studied diet is that of the plant-based Mediterranean-style diet. If we increase the intake of fruits, vegetables, healthy nuts, monounsaturated fats such as avocado and olive oil, all of these things actually help to reduce the development of cardiovascular disease. Some studies would suggest by up to about 30%.
So, I mean, eating those fruits and vegetables, staying away from the fried and the sugary foods, that's all pretty much common sense at this point. There's a lot of opinions out there about how much exercise you need, what kind of exercise is best. As far as heart and vascular health, what do you think works best?
So in general, I tend to recommend 40 minutes of physical activity about 4 days a week. And it really should be a combination of both cardiorespiratory fitness training, so something like running or biking or swimming, and some resistance training as well. So do focus on your muscles. Strengthening up your muscles is a big part of not only your cardiovascular fitness, but also for balance and mobility as well. Exercise is so important that it's so good for not only cardiovascular health, but also for mental health too. And we have seen studies that suggest when your mental health is better, when your anxiety is better, when your depression is under control, then your cardiovascular health is also better too.
If you would like more information, you can visit OrlandoHealth.com/heart.